clock. So I'm all over the place, and you know why, don't you?
Fiddling.
I know. Neil Tymon's in the studio this morning, would you believe? Is he there?
He's over there.
Neil, there he is.
No
there
problem.
He is.
Very
poised.
Good morning. Very good morning.
Poised, ready to deliver.
Oh, just about keeping my eyes open.
Oh, well, yeah, that's a struggle for all of us.
Welcome to GMTV.
Thank you, Andrew.
He's got a very big talk.
Biggest challenge for all of us.
He has. We'll be talking about that, and he'll be performing as well. But when we come back, it's all aboard with Richard Arnold, who's on a bus, man.
Got to be careful. Or is it just
the
press
turning? She needs to learn from a real star, doesn't she, Andrew? She needs to learn from someone like the likes of Neil Diamond here.
Okay.
You wouldn't leave your fans standing for 2 hours in the rain, would you?
I might if I had to get my hair wet and get, you know.
You wouldn't mind getting your hair wet.
A star has to look perfect at all times, and Britney knows that. You know, it's the first lesson of stardom.
You've got to look good.
Look good.
You'll get
forget about
by a camera. It'll live with you forever.
Exactly.
Won't you?
Yeah. Exactly. Forget about talent. Just look good.
Is there an element of sarcasm going on here, Neil? Do I detect?
Well, I mean, it's true. You know. It's such a visual age that the audience forms an impression really based on your looks, and yeah, so this is the way it is now. I think before television, before all the MTV and films, but mostly before the cable and satellites, there wasn't quite as much emphasis on just physical appearance, and now it's all appearance and youth, and you know.
Do you find that actually? Do you think that? Because of course you started because you were given a guitar and you wanted to play.
I wanted to make music. Yes.
Yeah. And do you feel that's very different now?
I think it's different. It's more about the celebrity and that whole thing, because people are fascinated by that. You
know. There's no guitars anymore either. I mean, there's so little guitar music
exactly.
in a popular area.
That's right. It's all synthesizers and. But there's always been a fascination with celebrity and fame, and I guess it'll always go on.
And is it fun? Because you're the celebrity.
Yeah, it's kind of fun. You know, if you could just control it somewhat, to just take it in dosage when you want it. But I mean, that's the unfun part of it, that you really can't control it, and it's there whenever. You know, you're out, and whether you want it or not.
And do you find that people, wherever you go, I mean, you could be on the moon, couldn't you, and people come up to you?
I'd be surprised on the moon, but yes, I have people come up to me all the time, and it's nice. There's always a little story that goes with it, you know. My mom used to play it, or I used to listen on the, you know, when I woke up.
When I woke up, yeah, yes. Exactly, when I had earache, when I was
it's
at home,
wonderful.
And all that kind of stuff.
You know, you're working kind of isolated in Los Angeles, or you're performing, and yet to know that you have a little kind of impact on people's lives.
It's fantastic.
And all over.
Well, you certainly
nice.
Have an impact. I mean, we mentioned only sort of within the last hour that you're going to be on, and people already started ringing in. Ali Middleton from Aberdeen says that she's going to see you in concert in Glasgow, because that's
wonderful.
Where you're here, aren't you? You're on tour.
Yes, we're starting in Glasgow, and we work our way down to London.
Yeah, and she says, do you still have the same buzz about performing? Do you ever have an off night, and could it not be on Thursday the 11th of July, please? Because that's when she's going to see you.
It definitely won't be on Thursday, July 11th, because we'll be ready by then. Sometimes you have an off night. You're physically not as well as you might be, but no, I've never lost the buzz. I'm always a little nervous. I'm scared, you know, coming up with this tour, and I've been touring through England for 30 years, and, you know, I think the audience knows me and knows what to look forward to.
So when you pull on your uniform for the night.
Exactly.
Something like this.
Look
well,
at
I did,
this.
Yes, that's.
Have
kind
a look. That's a,
look
that's a fantastic
isn't
shirt,
wicked?
Isn't it?
It's heavy as well. I didn't know
oh, yes.
it was heavy.
Well, it's all hand beaded and glass beads, and it's handmade. It's wonderful. I had that made for a New Year's Eve performance in Las Vegas, because if you can't wear pink in Las Vegas, you know, you can't wear it anywhere. And I have all kinds of colors, but not pink.
Well, thank you for this, because we're going to be auctioning this.
I heard about
this,
that.
Haven't you?
Forget
yes,
up and give.
Yes,
that's
and
really
I hope I hope somebody spends a lot of money on it, because I know I did. And you know, I hope they don't wear it out. You know, that's.
It's not,
no,
it's
exactly.
not something that's going to work everywhere in Britain.
No, it's
no.
not going to work down your local,
no,
but it's a fantastic thing to have. So that you are donating, Neil, for our Get Up and Give Charity Appeals, so we'll be talking about that next week.
Good.
You have the chance to win that one. Do you like performing in the UK?
Oh, yes. It's, as I said, we've been performing in the States now, and I've played about 80 cities or so in the States. And I love this show that we're doing. I'm very excited about it. We have a string section and a horn section, so I wanted to bring it to as many places as possible, but Coming to the UK is special. It's exotic for us. It's very different
you
than Pittsburgh.
This. How can we be exotic? We don't
oh,
feel very exotic.
You're an exotic
in the UK,
group. You're very exotic. A lot of wonderful, wonderful Englishmen. But I remember the last time we were here, we took the train through the from city to city, and yeah. The first time we pulled into England on the train. It was wonderful. The train stopped in the middle of nowhere. There were no stations, and there were just some people in the houses. It was right by the tracks, and saw two wonderful people, a couple in their backyard, and we all got to the window to see this new strange breed, you know, like at a zoo. Oh, look, yeah. They're English people, and they're so nice, and look how nice they are. And they were waving back to us, and we were waving to them, and. The train just started to move off very slowly, and as it did, they both turned and walked back to the house, and as we gave them our last wave and last goodbye, they dropped their trousers and mooned us.
No!
So, I mean, this is an exotic population that we've got to investigate this further.
I can't apologize enough, Neil. I can't apologize enough. That's so embarrassing. But you see, your cup is so
we're not used to people doing that to us. We usually do it to them first, you know. But they were so nice and pleasant. We can't, no, let's not moon them. They mooned us.
You see, your cup is obviously half full because we get that a lot when trains stop in the middle of nowhere over here in the UK.
We I had no
the
idea.
The trains aren't running. But you see it as a beautiful moment.
Oh, it was wonderful. It told us so much about the English mind. Twisted and yet beautiful.
We're all going to need some nationwide therapy, I think, after that. But Neil, thanks very much indeed. You are going to be performing for us, aren't you? Which
yes,
is brilliant live
wonderful.
This morning. So we're going to take a quick break so you can get over and into position.
Thank you.
Fantastic
and first,
to
you
meet
must,
you.
You must stick around. We've got some gardening tips. You are going to love this, Neil.
I want to learn something.
Yeah, this is a bit more about our psyche now.
That's right. You want to know about Britain? Here's Carl Wilde.
Did us prepare you for the holiday of...
Thank you very much. What did you think? Neil Diamond, for Get Up and Give. This is it. What do you think? Goes with the tie. Neil? What do you say?
I'm scared. I mean, I just look at that and I say, this is it. My career is over and yours has just begun. With a tie under it, I like that.
It goes, doesn't it?
It does.
Tell me about Sweet Caroline. Where did the song come from? Such a success.
You know, people have asked where I got the name, and I never really thought about it. Where? I thought it was just a name. I do think now that, thinking back on it, that maybe it was Caroline Kennedy. Because I wrote it about that time, and she was very much in the news. So
nice.
If I had someone, but that song was written just before the recording session. It took about a half hour, and I think it's been my biggest song ever.
Well, it's fantastic, and we're looking forward to
Thank
it.
Thank you so much.
Neil Diamond.
Thank you, Andrew. Take that shirt off. It feels frightening.
Where it began, I can't begin to know it, but then I know that it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring, spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you. It don't seem so lonely. We fill it up with only two. And when I hurt, hurt runs off my shoulders. How can I hurt when I'm holding you? Warm. tugging warm, reaching out, touching me, touching you. Sweet Caroline, good times never seem so good. Good times never seem so good.
You got it.
I've been inclined to believe they never would. Sweet
I think you've got a big, I think you've got a big future. What was your name again?
Let's not get into it.
Oh, Neil, thank you so much for
what
that. Neil Diamond. Yeah, it's
brilliant.
Good stuff, wasn't it?
Singing like
can
that.
I just say, your hair, when you...
Are
you
my a, hair's were been you a, Neil Diamonded, I'm
were
afraid.
You a headbanger when
yeah,
you were a kid?
It's all
did you
over
shake
the place, the whole thing.
Lovely. Okay,
we're going to hear more. Yeah,
E.T. is going to be in Ben
today.
And Jenny a little bit later on. And if you are a big Neil Diamond fan, head for our website, because one of his stage shirts is being auctioned, the one that I was just ruining, along with lots of other star items for Get Up and Give next week. That's gmtv.co.uk.
Right, we're checking out the weekend's telly next.